One more problem on a Kaplan turbine, which is a reaction turbine. I have selected problem number 28 from the question bank. A Kaplan turbine operating under a net head of 20 meters. Net head of 20 meters develops 20,000 kilowatt. 20,000 kilowatt. That is the power, with an overall efficiency of 86%, that is 0.86. The speed ratio is 2. And flow ratio is 0.6. The hub diameter, hub or boss, it is called dia of boss, is the hub diameter is 0.35 times the dia of the runner. Die of the wheel. Find the diameter and speed of the turbine. Find die of turbine, die of the wheel, and speed of the turbine. This is the problem. This is on Kaplan turbine. This problem is on Kaplan turbine. Now, first, what we do is efficiency is equal to same T by WQH. From here I can get Q. Q will be P divided by efficiency into WH. P is given 20,000 divided by efficiency is 0.86. W is constant 9.81. H is 20 meters. So now we have substituted it. Take the calculator. 20,000 divided by 0.86 divided by 9.81 divided by 20. That will give me 118.5 cubic meters per second. This is the discharge required. Discharge. Next, velocity with which the water is entering, capital V is equal to Cv into root 2 gh. Cv is not given. They have not given Cv. So it will be taken as 1. It will be assumed as 1 whenever it is not given. 2 into 9.81. into H is 20. So 2 into 9.81 into 20 is this much. Root of that answer, 19.8 meters per second. Now speed ratio means small v by capital V. Speed ratio means small v divided by capital V. This is inlet velocity of water. This is the velocity of wheel. Small v is equal to speed ratio into capital V, that is 2 into 19.8, that is 19.8 into 2 will give me 39.6 meters per second. So I have got Q, V and small v. Next. Next. Q is how much? 118.5 cubic meters per second. Capital V is 19.8 meters per second. Small V is 39.6 meters per second. Now, I have got these answers. Now, flow ratio. Flow ratio stands for Vf by V. Vf means velocity of flow. It is the vertical component of this V, capital V. Now, this is given. How much is this? 0.6. Flow ratio is 0.6 is equal to Vf by V. So, velocity of flow, Vf will be equal to 0.6 V, that is 0.6 into 19.8. 0.6 into 19.8, that gives me 11.88 meters per second. 11.88 meters per second. Now, Q here, Q is equal to pi by 4 into d square minus dB square into Vf. See, in a Kaplan turbine, we have the shaft like this. This is called the boss. These are the blades, vanes. This is capital D. This is called dB. dB, the water is flowing here. So, it will be taken as pi, the area of flow will be pi by 4 into d square minus dB square into velocity of flow. Now, I know Q, I know Vf. Now, dB can be substituted in terms of d. So, only one unknown will be there, that will be capital D. Now, 118.5 is equal to pi by 4 into d square minus 0.35 d the whole square into Vf. Vf is 11.88. So, now what happens here is, If I square this, 0.35 square will be equal to 0.1225. Here it is 1 d square. So 1 minus answer will give me 0.8775. 118.5. is equal to pi by 4 into 0.8775 d square into 11.88. So, capital D, that is the dia of the runner we want, dia of this runner, D will be equal to under square root 118.5 into 4 divided by pi into 0.8775 into 11.88. So, that will be 118.5 into 4 divided by pi divided by 0.8775 divided by 11.88 equals under root, root answer. So this will come as 3.8 meters. This is the dia of the runner, dia of the runner. Next, we want speed of the runner. To find the speed of the runner, this small v, that is speed of velocity of the runner, small v we call it, v is equal to pi dn by 60. Now we know v, v is 39.6, we know capital D, that is 3.8, substitute that and we have to get n. So n will be equal to 60V divided by pi D, that is 60 into 39.6 divided by pi into 3.8. Which gives me 199.027. You can take it as 199 rpm or 200 rpm. That is the speed of the turrunner. Speed of the turbine, that also is got. So that finishes the problem. You can comment, like, share the video and subscribe. Thank you.